is kind of a impromptu video. I've come to my little wild camping spot, local of course. I wasn't going to film, but it's so beautiful I really wanted to. I've brought a little stove, wood stove, that I want to test out. I've never used it before. I'm not very good at making a fire, so I thought I'd give it a go. But yeah, it's so pretty here. It's everywhere, the snow's melted apart from this bit, so the sun doesn't really, although it looks like it, it's sun shining through, but it doesn't really get to this spot. It's usually quite cold, but it's lovely and peaceful. There's no one about. Love it. So that's the stove, comes in a little black case. It was only a tenner off eBay. But yeah, I've not got anything to cook on it, I'm just lighting it and, well, if I can light it, that is. But just wanted to get out and about really, as always. But it's just really pretty down here, so. It's like my go-to place. There we go, I've done it. So it's a little bit fiddly at first, but you just have to put it the right way and then it's much easier. So it's all set up, get a little fire going. Thank you. Cool. I'm 100% not an expert on making fires, but I brought some wood from home, some dry wood. Not much, because I'm not staying here overnight or anything. I just wanted to test it out. But yeah, it's cool. I like it. It'd be nice for just like afternoon walks and chilling in the woods for the day, you know, that kind of thing. And I like it because it obviously keeps the fire off the ground. But for a tenner, can't really beat that. Once you've got like the embers of, you've got quite a few embers and stuff, you can put a pan on top and cook on it. Comes with these, so they sit on top and you can just put a little pan on or cup or something. Yeah, that's cool. It's just everything's wet through, but never mind. I did find a bit of wood when I was walking in that was much drier, like, you know, it's come off the trees and stuff, but I'm not staying for long. I've brought my jet boil, so I'm going to get that out in a minute, make a brew and some noodles and then head home. But it's been a nice afternoon, nice to get the dog out, do something a bit different. Nice. Starting to wish I brought more wood now, because the wood really is just wet through. If I had an axe and everything, I could split it. And well, I brought a knife, but I couldn't be bothered bringing that today. It's just a quick one, just a quick one. But it would have been nice to stay overnight, but I can't do that of the lockdown. So gonna make a brew now. up my mess and then head off back home, I think. Slowly starting to set now. Looks like it's going to be a really nice sunset, to be honest. So just getting packed up, so stove's all gone out and everything, and I've nearly finished my brew, so I'm going to head up that hill and watch a bit of the sunset. I think these people who just come to places and just ruin it, they're taking that out with me, won't be leaving it here. Find some more rubbish, which I'm going to take away with me. Yeah, all ready to go. Bags packed. That's where my little fire. This fire pit has been here for years. I've been coming to this spot doing like the odd wild camp. I've been coming probably 5 or 6 years. It's been there the whole time. And every time we've left it, or I've left it, it's, you know, kind of been left as inconspicuous as possible. There's all these rocks that have been placed here as well. I don't know, it's just been here for years. But there is a path that runs through, and I think, I don't think it's not regularly used, but I have seen footprints today, so I think people do still use it. Yeah, so I'm just having a little rant now, but it's got to be done sometimes. So this is like my favourite place to come in my local area. About 15-20 minute drive. And it's quite a long walk in. And you've got to come off the path to get to it. So if you're going to make the effort to come all the way down here, then at least make the effort to take your rubbish with you. You know, most people have got coats on at this time of year, just put your rubbish in your pocket. But yeah, if there's anybody who might be watching this and is thinking of starting going walking and camping, or they're just starting out, the rule is, and always has been forever, leave no trace. Leave only footprints. You know, these places are so important to us. It just helps your mental health, helps physically, and it's our duty to just take care of them. And we've got to keep it nice for generations to come. Yeah, but it's true though, like, it's such a beautiful area around here, and places are just, habitats are being lost, and places are being ruined and bulldozed to make way for train lines. You know, it's so nice here, and around where I live there aren't very many nice places, to be honest. They aren't looked after, so coming down here today and seeing rubbish, it's just upsetting. So yeah, leave no trace, guys, please. If not for yourselves, for the children of the future. But yeah, like, everyone's entitled to get out and about and enjoy themselves. You know, people are realising what is actually important now. And we've got to look after it, otherwise we'll lose it, don't we? And it just helps make the place look nicer. Yeah, so that's my little speech over with. So I'm all packed up now, I didn't really plan on filming this video, I'm just filming it on my phone. But yeah, I'm gonna head up the hill now, watch the sunset, get back. It's been lovely. It's very cold. I've been making Lassie run around so she doesn't get cold. And yeah, we've not been here for long. It's not an RSPCA case, don't worry. But yeah, thank you for watching. I'm gonna do a proper video cooking on that little stove because it's pretty cool. But I'll probably, when it gets a bit warmer because it's cold now, and then also when lockdown is over with, I am out of here. I'm getting out there and taking my tent somewhere and going on a nice camp. But yeah, thanks for watching, like and subscribe, see you later. It's gonna be a nice sunset.